गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, इन टूडेज क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टेम्परेचर आर थर्मल स्ट्रेसेस ऑन एनी एलिमेंट. इन अर्लियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द स्ट्रेसेस विच आर जनरली प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई द एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेस ऑन एनी एलिमेंट. नाउ इन दिस क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टेम्परेचर स्ट्रेसेस. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द क्लास. Basically, the temperature stress will produce in any element when the temperature of any element will vary from the standard temperature of that particular element. Okay, so if we talk about the temperature stress, when will the temperature stress produce on any element? So suppose we have a component whose length is L, modulus of elasticity is E, coefficient of thermal expansion is alpha, and the variation in temperature is del T. Suppose the standard temperature of the material or member is T, and the change in temperature with the standard temperature is del T. That particular material will deform, will expand or contract as per that variation in temperature. If temperature will decrease, the member will contract, and if temperature will increase, the member will expand. So according to the variation, the deformation will occur on the member, and the amount of deformation can be calculate change in length due to temperature variation. Del L will be equal to L alpha delta T. Okay. So by using that formula, we can calculate the change in dimension or change in length due to the temperature variation. Here, the length is a constant value, length is known value of the element, del T is temperature, and alpha. Alpha is a very important parameter here, because with the help of alpha, we can identify the amount of change. How much change in material due to the variation of temperature, and with the help of alpha we can compare the amount of change in two different material. If we have alpha 1 and alpha 2, and if alpha 1 is greater than alpha 2, alpha 1 is the coefficient of thermal expansion for a member, and alpha 2 is coefficient of thermal expansion for another element or material. And if there is a change in temperature, so due to that particular change in temperature, the variation or change in first material will be more as compared to the second material. If the temperature is decreasing, the contraction on the first material will be higher as compared to second material, and if temperature is increasing, the expansion of the first material will be more as compared to the second material. So with the help of alpha, with the help of coefficient of thermal expansion, we can identify the amount of variation or amount of change in dimension of two different materials. Okay, so with the help of that particular formula, we can calculate the change in length of any element due to the temperature variation. But if the material is free to expand due to temperature variation or free to contract due to temperature variation, the stress will not produce here. Okay, as long as we will not restrict the expansion or contraction due to temperature variation, the stress will not produce on any element. So for the temperature stress, or for gaining the temperature stress, we have to restrict the variation of any element due to temperature change. So at that condition, only the expansion will occur, but no any amount of stress will occur, will produce in that particular member or bar. Okay, for getting the temperature stress, we have to restrict the variation or change in dimension. So here, if we have a component and we have supported the element, here the change in temperature is del T, suppose length is L, and coefficient of thermal expansion is alpha, and modulus of elasticity is E. Here, if temperature variation is occur due to that particular temperature variation, the material will try to expand or contract as per the variation. Okay, but actually the support condition will not allow it to move, and at that particular situation the temperature stress will produce. Okay, how we can calculate here? If the change in temperature we have known and change in dimension we know and the original dimension also we have, here we can calculate the strain due to temperature variation. So strain on element, strain equal to change in dimension by original dimension, change in dimension divided by original dimension. So here the strain will be equal to del L divided by L and epsilon will be equal to del L means L alpha delta T divided by L. L will be cancel out and the strain will be equal to alpha delta T and that is thermal strain. And if we get the strain we can calculate the stress very easily. So temperature stress sigma T will be stress equal to strain into modulus of elasticity and we have the value of strain here alpha delta T and modulus of elasticity is E. That will be the thermal stress. So if we have restricted the change of any element due to the variation of temperature at that particular situation we will get the value of temperature stress equal to alpha delta T into E, right? So basically at the time of calculating, at the time of finding thermal stress, we can explain express this as thermal stress will be equal to thermal strain prevented into modulus of elasticity. That term is very important, prevented. And the thermal strain is del L by L and del L prevented into E. That is important. How much the change we have prevented due to only due to that particular change in length the thermal stress will produce. So at the time of calculating thermal stress we should aware about the prevented change in length, right? With the help of that concept we can calculate the thermal or temperature stress. Here if we suppose we have considered a beam, a bar whose first end is fixed and other end is free. Again we have considered a bar whose first end is fixed and second end is also supported but some amount of change is allowed here. That del amount of change is allowed here. And another rod we have taken here whose both end is fixed. No any amount of expansion is allowed here. So here we have taken three cases and we will check here where how much amount of temperature stress will produce if it and the original length of the rod is L. So if we talk about the change in length due to temperature variation, if the variation in temperature is del T in all the rods, so the change in length due to the temperature variation will should be equal to L alpha delta T. In all the three rods, the change should be equal to L alpha delta T. If we talk about the case number first, here the expansion or change in length of that particular amount is free. That particular rod will expand by that amount of value freely. Here the expansion or contraction is not prevented. So here del L prevented is zero. If del L prevented is zero, then thermal stress will also be equal to zero. So for that particular case, the temperature stress or thermal stress will be equal to zero. If we talk about second case, here del L prevented will be equal to the original value what should occur due to the temperature variation, that is L alpha delta T, del L. एंड द एक्सपांसन फ्री एक्सपांसन व्हाट हैव अलाउड हियर दैट इज डेल. तो डेल एल प्रिवेंटेड विल ऑकर आफ्टर द एक्सपांसन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट. सो बाय सब्सट्रैक्टिंग द फ्री एक्सपांसन फ्रॉम द टोटल चेंज वी विल गेट द प्रिवेंटेड डेल एल. एंड इफ वी गेट द प्रिवेंटेड डेल एल द थर्मल स्ट्रेस वी कैन कैलकुलेट हियर इजली दैट इज डेल एल प्रिवेंटेड डिवाइड बाई ओरिजिनल लेंथ इन टू ई. इन थर्ड केस डेल एल प्रिवेंटेड हियर द बोथ एंड आर रिस्ट्रिक्टेड सो द टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ चेंज ड्यू टू द टेम्परेचर विल बी प्रिवेंटेड हियर. सो डेल एल प्रिवेंटेड हियर इज इक्वल टू डेल एल. That much amount of change will be prevented here. So the total change in length will be the del L prevented. And we can calculate the temperature of thermal stress del T equal to del L prevented divided by L into E. So that is important how much amount of expansion is prevented due to that particular expansion what have been prevented only the temperature stress will produce. And if we talk about the nature of the stress, what type of stress will produce due to the temperature variation? If we have an element and whose both end is prevented, if we are increasing the temperature with the standard temperature, if we will increase the temperature, the body will tend to expand. But the restricted end will not allow it and impose a compressive nature load here in the element. So due to the compressive nature load, the stress will also be compressive. So if the temperature is increasing, the nature of stress will be compressive. Second case, again we have considered a rod and here we have decrease the temperature with the standard temperature. So when the temperature will be decreased, the body will try to contract, body will try to shrink, but the restricted end will not allow it to shrink and they will impose the tensile nature of load at the end. The due to the tensile nature of load, the nature of the stress will be tensile. So if the variation in temperature is decreasing nature, the stress will be of tensile nature. Tensile stress will produce here. So by that concept we can identify the nature of the stress due to the temperature variation. That's all for today. Thank you.